Hello, everybody. Good to see you once again in Astroneer. I've got some exciting stuff to show you today, like a partial eclipse. I don't know, I thought that was pretty neat. I've been exploring in the truck with our handy-dandy crane plus drill combination, and I found my first deposit of rich resin. Well, rich deposit of resin, rather. I've already harvested all of it into my bags, and I wish that I had some compound for a beacon so that I could throw a beacon down over here and possibly reuse the resin in the future, since it has been so scarce. But speaking of compound, there's the first deposit of compound that I think that I found. Correct me if I'm wrong, maybe I have found like one other, but it seems so rare by comparison to the other planets that I was inspecting for possible habitation. What I'm doing is out looking for the rarer resources. Compound's gonna be good because we still have many platforms back home that need it. So in total, I really need something more akin to like 6 separate units of compound, and I don't think that we can squeeze that many in. I've got some extra power I'm just gonna drop. I was carrying that for nighttime excursions with the truck here. After shifting the power around a little bit, I think I've got as much compound as we're gonna find in this little deposit. So I'm gonna continue on the way home. The goal again for today, linking up the vehicles, hooking up a winch, figuring out what it does, and some of you have given me some tips as to what the crane might be good for, sans drill head. So that's gonna be something worth experimenting on as well. Now what do we have here? This rock formation looks like it is guarding more lithium, another good use for the crane, but I still have not used the lithium that we found yesterday, so I'm just gonna try to remember that it's out there for now and continue to keep an eye out for other rarities. See hydrazine everywhere. That's definitely the most plentiful resource here on Tundra, at least on the surface, which is unfortunate because it is otherwise free as long as you have a fuel condenser, right? Oh, this is big. This is the titanium deposit I've been looking for. This means I'm gonna be able to make the winch. The winch needs 2 smelted titanium. Well, does it have to be smelted? Let's find out. I've got power on the back of the drill. I'm gonna probably need to remove that or otherwise stop the vehicle from sliding downhill. I moved the truck a bit to try to create this curb behind it so it wouldn't move. And I hear the sandstorm rising towards us. I think we'll be safe as long as we're in the crane. Let's do a little experiment and find out. I feel very exposed, I do. I wonder if any of those big box projectiles are gonna instant kill me while I'm in the back of this. They might push the titanium that we're harvesting away from us, which is kind of scary. We really don't want to lose that. This is the worst time I could possibly be trying to use the crane, but I like living life on the edge. I didn't need a curb. I needed to create a box wall around us because all of these little rods are pushing me so far away. You want the storage container so you don't have problems like this. This isn't even one full unit of titanium, is it? We got the compound, we got the resin. Let's go ahead and stick those on our shoulders, and then we will have room for the stuff that we've been digging out over here. So 2 more units of titanium, and it looks like we might have been able to get a 3rd out of this if we hadn't somehow shot off a half-baked unit. I think I'm gonna go ahead and head home now and try to remember where this little pit is. It's just a few feet away from our spaceship, which is still loaded with compound from back home. I had completely forgotten about that. I should probably go use that. I shouldn't have been so excited about the patch that we just found. Either way, I digress. The hop, skip, and a jump to go back home. And we're gonna try linking up the vehicles. I still have no aluminum. I'd really like to link up 2 trucks. I've got 1 aluminum. We've got quite the laundry list of things to do, don't we? Platforms, research, winch, link vehicles, find aluminum, and more. Let's start with the platform since we just got a bunch of resin and compound. Trade platform could use aluminum, but we're in short supply. We've got the printer. Fuel condenser, we don't need. Research. I say let's go for the research right now. Why was that button lit up before I had put the resources down? Is it because of the zebra ball from last episode? Why is this here? I don't know, but I'm afraid it's gonna roll away, so I've put it here for now, and it shrinks down for reasons unbeknownst to me. Well, I'm happy that the research bench is at least receiving some power, so let's see what we get. I'm expecting a resource, but maybe not. Is there anything left for us to discover? Hold on, what? nothing came out of that, right? Am I going crazy? Have we researched 100% of the stuff in the game? But why wouldn't I get just a little unit resource to spend? And if that's true, I don't know. But either way, at least we finally researched that thing. And I've got two more resin. Let's make one more platform, shall we? I kind of want to do it over here. If I can stop falling in this infinite pit. That looks good. A little bit of room for future expansion. Now I've got two titanium next on the laundry checklist. It's to head on over to storage and find the winch and try to figure out what it does. There it is. Okay, two titanium, which does not need to be smelted, by the way, confirmed. I think this is the first time I found raw titanium, but my memory has been known to fail before. Certainly the first item that we can make with titanium, in the printer at least, this looks like a harpoon gun. Please make a harpoon gun. I think I'm just gonna have to move the solar panel off to find out what this is good for. Definitely for carrying something, but I'm not sure what. But you see, half of the fun of Astroneer is not knowing. It's also falling out of your vehicle time and time again. And the other half of the Astroneer fun is getting hit by windstorms every 2.5 minutes. All right, we're gonna head into this shallow pass here. Did you see that it wanted me to connect the two vehicles, but we're gonna try to connect them in a different way. I'm gonna get out. I know it's dangerous. Check this out. We can left click on the winch and then drag out this huge pipe, shoot it at the vehicle. Okay, get back in before the boxes kill us. The winch is connected. Do you see it with the light? I know it's dusty here. I know it's difficult to see what's going on. I think we're pulling it around. Probably the least efficient way to do this imaginable. We're gonna try going home. I'm gonna turn around and watch to see what the damage is here. I think the winch disconnected itself. It is not invulnerable, sadly. How about this little rock? Now that the sandstorm has passed, you might be able to see what I'm doing better. We latch it on, use the power of the truck, try to yank it from its earthly surface, or it pulls us around. It was a good try. Maybe it's not completely loose or free yet. You probably can't do it if it's still got a little bit buried in the soil. There, now that it can move freely, of course we can just pick this research up ourselves, but still, I think this is worth a try. But it might be more trouble than it's worth. Additionally, we are almost out of power and Master Chief style. I can't seem to flip the warthog over correctly. Let's give it one more go. Attach it to the rock, and we're gonna be able to lift giant boulders with the strength of our truck, right? Come with me if you want to live. Careful! We're not bowling for the colony here. It's like we're carrying a giant styrofoam rock now. I'm completely out of energy. I believe I have found an interesting quirk of the winch. We may not be strong enough to lift a boulder, but we are strong enough to carry a winch, which in turn is strong enough to lift a boulder. Physics! Don't question it, ladies and gentlemen. This is how the game was meant to be played. With rock flails. Uh-oh. Now you've gone and done it, Etalyx. Use your telekinetic mind freeze powers to stop the destruction before it starts. One more try. Why does this work? I hope they never fix that. I'd rather it never disconnect so we could just swing it around. And in multiplayer, just one-shot kill other players. You launch a rock at them. Where did that come from? Do not ask me why I've done this. Yeah, I created that ramp. Yes, I drove the truck down the ramp. There's no way to get out if I run out of power. You understand? There's no solar. There's nothing else attached to this. Just the crane and a storage bin. Unfortunately, coal does not power this vehicle. I have to find exclusively little yellow things in the ground, like here, for example, around the spike traps. So let me try to gather some of that up now. I've already been trying to get some power. And what I'm gonna have to do, no doubt, is put the storage bin on the ground and then open up my pack and take the power to recharge us, like so. As long as I can find these little power packs, we'll be okay. So I'm gonna save the other one for now. Looks like we've topped off nicely. And I'm gonna create a path for us to get through. I'm not sure if you can be spiked to death while inside a vehicle. nor do I intend to find out. Oh my God, what is that behind us? What is this? Why is there a person over here? It's another me, except he's got green arms instead of blue. For a moment, I thought that I found the Astroneer version of Hero Brain or something. He's got loot for us, though. He's frozen in this cross formation for all eternity. How sad. He's got an oxygen tank. It's actually kind of impressive. We're down to 50% already. I've been kind of dilly-dallying a bit. He's got some aluminum for us. That's very nice of him. Titanium and another oxygen tank. Hold on. That's not even everything. There's more stuff just sitting on the ground. Does that say dynamite? Woo! That does say dynamite! It just tick-tick boomed right on top of me. I thought that I was picking it up. I didn't know I was detonating it. You have anything else for us here? I see more double-up resources, but you can't pick up any of these. They're just visual bugs, I suppose. Resin, probably not all that important for us right now. And my pack is now full of quadruple oxygen. I bet we can run for miles without any additional help whatsoever, without ever needing to come back. The problem, however, is that this is a bad place to turn. Navigating through here with the truck looks nigh impossible, but finding that loot was pretty sweet. Something new. Had no idea that there were potential other dead Astroneers here. We are not the first to this planet. We thought that we were, but no, life has come here before and died down here in the mines, and I promise that was not my corpse. You should be able to tell because it was a completely different skin from the one that I'm using, and it was standing upright, which is creepy enough on its own. We're bouncing right along, just cruising through the cave into a real resource-rich hole in the ground. That could be lithium behind us, copper to the right, hydrazine, more copper on the roof, and most importantly, perhaps, aluminum. Mind you, I've no idea which way we came through here. I've no idea how to get out, but ultimately that's not important. I just need the resource, and if I have to just dig straight up and create an infinite ramp to go back up to the surface to get this beautiful truck out of here, then so be it. That is what we'll do. Look at what I just found out you could do. I feel like I knew you could do this before, but I just forgot about it and never did it again. You can use the front and back of the vehicles for storage. So I've got my actual storage container on my bumper in the back, and now we got research on the front, and I've got a room for an extra research if I want it. Maybe I do, but that also frees up a slot for us to put power in. Now, the question of getting out, escape, finding a way home, to link up two trucks together and make the ultimate grinding machine. Is this a titanium deposit on top of everything else? Maybe the deeper you go, the more you are rewarded. Yeah, I would say so. 5 more feet in that direction, and I've got 2 more titanium deposits. Copper, everything everywhere, but I've gone too deep at this point. And more aluminum? They're just throwing themselves at me now, teasing me because I have no more room for them in my backpack. As if it wasn't difficult enough to escape. Look at what I found. More broken map. That is a shame. I'm not sure when that actually happened, but it's keeping me locked here inside to my doom. I've been so scared for so long. Don't ask me how long it took, but I found the surface at long last. I have dug to freedom. Now if only I can squeeze through this little gap. There's only a tiny little bit of the way to go. I can breathe again. No more claustrophobia. Now we just have to find where is home. I see the beacons. I see the waypoints. We're not lost. We've got aluminum. We've got resources. We've got enough power, hopefully, to make it over these hills to take sick jumps. Land that flip. Land that flip. That's right, that's what I'm talking about, Olympic gold medalist Etalyx coming in here with the car truck flips. And we're going back to link up the trucks, to build new ones, make ourselves a storage train. And I've got another huge idea for the winch. No problem at all. I had to ditch one of our researches because turns out when you put research on the very front of your car, you have a lot less room to go uphill. Well, there's a resource, titanium. I'd be surprised if we had anything left to research. The dynamite might have just been a trap or a one-off deal. I don't know. So let's get our storage on over here to the smelter. We'll get our aluminum fixed up. We'll make a brand new truck, and I wonder if we can make a truck without a seat. Let's find out. Drop the compound. Look at that. That's kind of cool, isn't it? Automatically takes the stuff off the smelter. I want to make sure there's enough room. And I know it has full energy. I think that's because of something that I did. I don't think it's possible for it to regenerate yet, unfortunately. Are you ready? Let's do it. The fourth and final aluminum is ready for truck number two. We are about to break Astroneer. Truck plus truck. That reminds me, let's go get the truck and see if we can't link them up. I kind of wish I could put the crane back on the other truck that we just got. It'd be cool to have this be like a utility vehicle and have it tow the crane around. I think that would be really neat. But I will take whatever I can get at this point, because for whatever reason, it looks like you cannot lift up the seat anymore. I was working on creating a flat path here to allow the linkage to go a little bit smoother. So let me try just smoothing out a little bit more of this terrain to kind of give us some area to work with to potentially back in truck number one. That looks pretty good. Wide berth. Speaking of backing it in, we don't want to plug it in from the front. So let's turn it around. And then W is going to back us up. I don't have my truck driver's license. This might take a minute. All right, that looks good. We don't want it to be too close, I guess. I've got a couple ideas for our new trailer, not least of which is a new battery. But before we do that, I'd really like to head back over to the spaceship, grab a whole bunch of compound, because it seems like all we've got here is resin, so that we can make a solar panel. We'll have infinite energy on the back of our trailer, which would be amazing. But for that, we need a wind turbine instead of a solar panel so we could, but it never seems to blow, even though you hear wind permanently. There's not actual wind blowing for whatever reason. Whatever, let's do the thing, shall we? Link it up, do the honors. So we're getting juice through the tubes. Now both of our vehicles have their own battery life. That should double the distance that we can go. What else can we make here? We've already got a crane. We don't need a second one, I don't think, and apparently I'm picking up a battery. May as well use it for now. We can always move it later. Storage is gonna take some compound. A seat, three seat, and a crane. Okay, so storage is probably what we want. Double up on storage. Sounds incredible. The maiden voyage of the linked up cars. The most requested thing. The winch earlier did not count. Oh, this is gonna be a struggle. We probably want a little bit more space between these two, don't we? How's this? Does that look way better? I think that looks way better. We need a longer trailer. So I'm going to take this with us all the way over to the spaceship, and I'm gonna zoom out as far as I can so you can kind of see how it works. It looks like the tube changes. So as it gets closer, it works like a seatbelt. When you pull a seatbelt out all the way in a car, that's what this little attachment looks like. It is so obnoxious. I guess it works. Somehow or another, it works. All right, compound. You have sat here on the spaceship for far too long. It's time to be used. And I know we don't have any good storage here yet, but six spots is still better than none. We'll optimize it in due time. And a little bit of research for the trailer. We're good to go. I still don't think there's anything left for us to discover, but nonetheless, I will take it back with us. There's not a way to manage your speed so you stop just yanking it back and forth. Once you hit top speed like this, it works a little bit better, but when you start making turns, the truck slides enough as it is when there's just one truck. When you throw in a second truck into the mix and start making these hard turns, you whip it around into those big old rocks. Whatever, it still works and it hasn't broken the game. So for that, I am thankful. I should probably park it close enough that we can hook back up to the grid at least. Like so. And like so. There we go. And probably pick up all the compound. I've got some in my backpack right now. I would like to use it to make the big storage, but to do that, we're gonna have to somehow back this into the vehicle bay. How is that even gonna work? After hundreds of comments, I've finally done it. Are you not entertained? I've connected the two vehicles. Thank you all so much for your continued support throughout this Astroneer series. Next time around, I want to link up even more vehicles for the ultimate industrial car chain train driving around at fast speeds, drilling through rocks, storing it all behind us, self-sufficient power-wise. That sounds cool. And I got one big idea left with the winch and something else cool I think you'll like. So stick around for the next episode. Let me know if there's anything left I need to try out in Astroneer down in the comments below. I do read all of them. I appreciate your help and support very much. I'll see you all next time back in this frozen tundra colony. But at least we have car friends now.